I invested $10,000 into 20 randomly generated stocks throughout the last 30 days.
Swipe up to purchase. Okay, we're 1,000 in.
The results were ridiculous.
Are you kidding me? Down 25% in one day?
Watch to the end to see how much money I made or lost by gambling $10,000 in the stock market. Here's how I did it.
So what we're gonna do is we're gonna use this algorithm right here, which is a random stock picker. For instance, if I were to click it, refresh, new stock ticker over and over and over. So yeah, it just randomly chooses tickers for you to buy, I guess in this case. I'm going to randomly select 20 stocks and then blindly invest $500 into each of those stocks. I'm gonna select one. Invest 500, repeat the process until all $10,000 is gone.
And the selection began.
Okay, the first stock is Vivo. Meridian Bioscience, down 0.77% today. Going to swipe up and buy 39 shares, see if it goes through. Okay, Vivo purchase, $501.91. ENLC, swipe up to purchase. Okay, we're 1,000 in.
And repeat the process.
Refresh, CBD. 21 of CBD purchased. AVAV, BNED, ALLO, GGT, TOLS, PBI, PIXI. Down 4% today, great. ARL, APTV, NLY, IBD, OTIC, EYEN, NEE, VEDL, JCAP, DJD. We're officially $10,000 in.
And here's Robinhood's little verification that I bought all these stocks. Keep in mind though, since the price of the stock varies, it's almost impossible to buy $500 flat of each stock. So I ended up buying a little more of one stock, a little less of the other. But at the end of the day though, I bought roughly $500 of 20 random stocks.
Okay, we're finally done. Randomly picked 20 random stocks off of this algorithmic generator. So it's gonna be interesting to measure how much I lose or make over the next 30 days.
And the investing began. Day one.
And here are the stats we have thus far. The biggest mover in only 24 hours is 6.7%. Allogene Therapeutics, a biotech company. It's up 7% today. It gave me a total of plus $33 as of now. The biggest loser is ENLC, natural gas company, down 5.4% on that. Out of all the stocks, gains and losses, I've ended up with a net gain of $77 today, which is roughly plus 0.77%. So almost up 1% in one day. Yeah, most of the stocks didn't move that much. We're talking roughly 0.2-0.3%. But some of the more wild stocks, the biotechs and whatnot, I had two or three that went up 4, 5, 6%. And then only really one big loser, which was ENLC, down $27 on that.
And for those of you who don't know what a stock is, you're basically buying a portion of a company. Let's say the publicly traded company we all know as Amazon has 1 million outstanding shares. If I were to buy one of those 1 million shares, I would, in theory, own 1 millionth of the company Amazon. Pretty epic, right?
Alrighty, folks, it has officially been 7 days since I bought my random portfolio of stocks in the stock market. I've achieved peace of mind when it comes to losing money arbitrarily and things like gambling in the stock market and whatnot. So I invested $500 in the Pitney Bowes, right? And I lost 24% of my principal in Pitney Bowes, PBI. Earnings for a lot of stocks are being reported throughout these next few weeks. There's going to be a lot of tumultuous movements literally all over the place. That's really going to do my portfolio in, I imagine, to some extent. Meridian Bioscience up 4% today, but I'm down 7% in total. ENLC down 5% today. I'm down $50 on that. Allogene, I'm up 6%, $30 in total.
And I'm no negative Nancy, but to be honest, my portfolio was getting absolutely wrecked. Down 2% in a little over a week. But you know, keep in mind I had 3 weeks to go. There was a lot of opportunity ahead. But as of now, my portfolio was deep in the red.
Sad as it is, oftentimes you'll have 50% of these stocks doing nothing. Two or three go up and then two or three go down. But the two or three that go down 20% and you're left in the negative.
Day nine.
Day nine of my portfolio in the market. And I'm pretty sure I'm down quite a bit of money. Barnes & Noble Education. It's a separate entity from Barnes & Noble. Organization, I don't know. It is down 6.16% today, $30 loss on that. ENLC down 11%. Aloe up 6%. That's my one stronghold right there.
Shout out to George R.R. Martin, because my portfolio was looking like the Red Wedding. No joke. Almost every single stock I had was in the red. I had my two or three strongholds here or there, but this video was proving itself to be a quick case study on how to lose $300 in less than 9 days. Ridiculous, I know.
21 more days to make a turnaround. But I think the sample size is large enough, meaning the fact that I've divided 500 amongst 20 stocks versus, let's say, 10 diversifies my risk to an extent in which there's a lot of variability that I think can go positively. I suppose that same principle operates on the negative side, as in me losing more money. But honestly, I don't really care at this point.
Day 12. Aw, hell yeah, boys. Turns out I do actually care about how this turns out. And my portfolio made a quick turnaround, and I recovered 100 big bones out of the 300 I lost. Not a bad recovery in a couple of days. It's almost as if the stock gods in the universe ordained a green revival and saved all of my dying stocks. Bless their souls.
17 of the 20 stocks I bought here are probably green, maybe plus 2% might be the average even. They made quite the recovery in only a day or two, which just shows the volatility of the market and the volatility of this particular portfolio of stocks. Maybe I'm up $1,000 at the end of day 30, and maybe at day 31, I'm down $2,000. But it's looking like I might not lose as much money as I thought. Alrighty, folks, after exhausting the power of my supercomputer to calculate some very intensive mathematics, it seems as if I am down officially $181.60.
But it only got worse.
It has been 15 days. Actually, today was the end of day 16, so I'm gonna do my halfway kind of catch-up review of what's gone down thus far. I checked my 20-stock portfolio. All the random stocks are looking pretty red. This shows my dollar loss. So scrolling down here, it looks like I lost maybe $100 today.
I was down much more than $100. That's right, a sum total of $466.43 I had lost, with 17 of the 20 stocks deep in the red. My biggest gainer was up 14.87%, and my biggest loser was down almost 24%, basically making my portfolio down a little less than 5% in roughly 2 weeks.
20 stocks I randomly invested in, only 3 of them are green. So that's roughly like a 3% downtick in the entire portfolio from 2-3 days ago. So what that means is that there's a lot of volatility in that portfolio. You know, I'm hoping it goes up by the end of these 14 days. Yeah, I'd prefer not to lose that much money. Could literally go in any given direction any day. But at the end of the 30 days, we're gonna compare my portfolio to what would have happened if I invested in mutual funds.
And if you don't know what mutual funds, or index funds in this case, are, basically think of it as a pretty accurate reflection of the entire stock market as a whole, meaning that however well the X amount of stocks in the stock market perform, it'll pretty accurately reflect that performance in the index fund or mutual fund. So I can compare the results of my random portfolio to that of an index fund like the S&P 500. Day 19.
19 days have passed. This is Sunday, right before the market opens on Monday. I'm down $429. Let me show you the prime offender here in my losses. Okay, Pitney Bowes. I'm down 26% on Pitney Bowes. This is the biggest loser by far. It's really killing my portfolio.
And to be honest, my entire portfolio was looking like a spicy Dorito. Basically, everything was red.
I only have a solid 8 active trading days to go here, so that's not a ton of time for this to turn around. So it looks like I'm gonna take a fat L. Yeah, everything's for the most part down 5-7%. And then I have some anomalies that are down 26%. So $430 out the window. Don't worry about me though. Stock losses are tax deductible. You already know.
Day 21.
Okay, officially 21 days has passed, but yesterday was a big day in a bad way. We're gonna call yesterday Black Monday or Darkness Monday, whatever you wanna call it. Bad day. My portfolio personally and our little test portfolio was down like 8% or something. Crazy, right? I saw it. I did a little holy prayer in my head, and then I just didn't really look into it too much. But from what I read briefly, there may have been some trade war tensions, you know, between the United States, China, and then I think earnings is also coming up. So my portfolio was down big time. My experimental portfolio for a 30-day challenge got hit pretty heavily too. And I am officially down $602.61. That is slightly more than 6% on the portfolio in 3 weeks, which is pretty horrible. It's a shame because my timing in the market as a whole was pretty bad. This month has led to very poor performance on all ends of my investments, especially though in the experimental portfolio. I think out of the 20 stocks I invested in, 15 of them are down. So that's kind of a lot. And then you have the occasional anomaly, which is down 10, 15, 20%. I think I have three or four of those big losers, but we need some big moves from these stocks in the next week or so. There's a saying among day traders, and it goes along the lines of holding and hoping is not a strategy. And that's exactly what I'm doing because can't do anything else. The idea behind that little axiom of truth, right, is that holding a stock without being convinced that it will go up in the future for any apparent reason is just basically buying a lottery as to whether or not it goes up or down. So that's basically what I'm doing. I'm essentially gambling this money, considering that I've done zero research on these stocks and that they're randomly selected. You know, the odds are without a doubt against my favor. But once again, that's the whole point of this experiment. So we'll see how this all plays out. I don't know what's gonna happen. Wish me luck.
Here's my personal portfolio.
Also, for those of you who have been wondering what app or trading platform I've been using this entire time, I've been using Robinhood, and I've used Robinhood for the last 3 years or so. And it's convenient because they don't charge any commissions, meaning you can buy and sell as many stocks as you want and you're not gonna get charged anything to do so. You can also buy and sell options, you can buy and sell cryptocurrency, and you can also get extra leverage if you get Robinhood Gold, upgrade your account a little bit. So it's pretty epic. My personal investment portfolio is in Robinhood, and I have quite a bit of money in 6 or 7 stocks, which is Nvidia, Facebook, Netflix, Amazon, Shopify, AMD, Square, and then just index funds like Dow Jones Industrial Index, S&P 500. I'm pretty bullish on e-commerce, so that's why I have some money in Amazon, Shopify, Netflix, don't know what I'm doing there, and then Square, once again, e-commerce. So that's the majority of my portfolio right there, nothing too crazy, but it's performed pretty well over the last month or so. In the last 3 months, it's up almost 5%, which is pretty solid, I'll take that. And I get some DMs here and there asking me what I do when it comes to stocks, etc. And in the past, I've day traded, I've swing traded, I've tried to sell and buy credit spreads and that sort of thing. But now I'm just a pretty passive investor. I just throw money into stocks and let them be. And for those of you who are interested in opening an account, you should totally use my little friend code on Robinhood, because if you do, it's a win-win-win and we both get a free stock apparently. So you can screw around with that free stock without actually putting any money into your Robinhood account. And I think the value of that stock ranges from like $5 to like a couple $100, but nonetheless, kind of neat. But yeah, that's the gist of my trading strategy and what I use to trade. Back to the video.
Day 25.
You know, it's been 25 days and every day that's gone by thus far, I've lost more money. I'm down $678.65, which is kind of a lot of money if you think about it. Honestly, I'd rather lose $700 trying to get a 4% return on my investment in the stock market than leaving it in the bank and getting a 0.2% return. You know, so screw it. Take my money, stock market. I'll get it back eventually. But beyond that, basically all there is left is a full trading week, which is Monday through Friday. So I have 5 active trading days for this portfolio to say, you know what? F this, turn around, become profitable, and make me some money. The Dow lately has been taking some fat hits. It's flopping like a Magikarp out of water. I don't know what's happening, what the root causes are, but the broad encompassing US economy, as reflected in the large index funds, is not doing too hot within these last 4 weeks. But no, I'm not losing any sleep over this.
It was in fate's hands.
It is 28 days in. It's like 4 in the morning right now. I just scrolled through the stocks and we had a fantastic green, beautiful day in the market, thank Christ. And the portfolio is up roughly $85. I'll take my blessings in any size at this point. That means I'm down, you know, almost at roughly $600 flat, which is tolerable. But I'm suspecting some big moves in the next 2 days. And if not, then I'm
Day 30, the final results.
We have Vivo down 11%, $57. ENLC down 12%, $60. CBD down 16%, $83. BNED down 20% almost, 19%, $95. AVAV down 3%, $14. Aloe down 1.6%, $8. GGT down 3.4%, down $17. Tolls down 0.34%, $1.65. PBI down 36%, $179. PIXY down 27.3% and $137. Jesus. ARL down 9%, down $45. APTV down 21%, $109. NLY down 8.26%, down $42. IBD up 0.12%, up 63 cents. OTIC, 0% move. EYEN, down 20%, down $104. NEE, up 6.5%, up $25. VEDL, down 7.4%, down $37.44. JCAP, up $1.86, 0.35%. DJD, down 2.71%, down $19. After calculating all the individual losses from each individual stock, I am down a sum total of $982.89. And what that means is that 16 out of the 20 stocks I invested in ended up deep in the red, oftentimes more than 10% down, and the portfolio ended up down 9.83%. The biggest loser out of those 20 stocks is PBI, down 35.64%. The biggest gainer was NEE, up 6.48%. And that is the tragic nature of my randomly selected portfolio. So if I were to have invested that $10,000 into the S&P 500, we're gonna use the SPY ETF as an example, I would only be down 2.38%. And my account performed almost four times worse. So this would have been a significantly better alternative to randomly selecting my stocks. If I were to have invested all of my money into the Dow, I would be down 3.72%, which is significantly better than the 9.83% I lost in my randomized portfolio. If I were to have thrown all that money into Amazon, I would only be down 2.23%. If I were to have invested my 10 grand in the most popular stock on Robinhood, I would be down 8.2%, which is still slightly better than the 9.83%. And if I were to have invested all of that money into Apple, I'd be down 11%, which is worse than my randomly selected portfolio. So the question from this entire experiment is, what are the takeaways? And here's what I've come to conclude. You're not going to research any of the stocks you're going to invest in, then you should probably just invest in index funds like the Dow or the S&P 500, and it seems like that would have been the average man's best bet. At the end of the day, I'm still pretty pro index funds, meaning the average person should probably just throw their money in the S&P 500 and the Dow Jones Industrial Index. That's my takeaway. One thing to also consider though is that this portfolio may have anomalously outperformed the Dow and the S&P 500 if we were to have timed this experiment in a different month, a different year, a different week, maybe a week before this, right? Who knows? So the outcomes could have been drastically different dependent upon when we entered into the market here. Our results really would have varied. But given that the indexes were only down 2-3% and this portfolio was down almost 10%, it's clear that randomly selecting a bunch of random stocks with zero research whatsoever, even into industries, past performance, etc., will most likely lead to a pretty bad result, unless you get lucky. So the moral of the story is, don't throw your money blindly into the stock market, and if you do, throw it into an index fund, because that's not really blindly investing, because it encompasses 500 plus stocks, and it's a specifically categorized group of stocks you're investing in rather than 20 individual stocks that could be hit or miss. If one of these stocks went down 100%, I'd automatically be down 5%. So by investing in the S&P 500, for instance, you can think of it as me investing $20 in 500 different stocks. If one of them goes down 100%, there's really not a lot of risk per individual stock. Diversification has its benefits. So now that I want to get these 20 stocks out of my portfolio, out of my life, I'm going to have to sell them. And I'm going to do what's known as tax loss harvesting, which is basically when you sell an investment at a loss to reduce your tax liability on your stock gains. With that being said, what are you guys invested? Are you invested in anything? Comment below. What's your take on investing in general? Should you invest in gold, stocks, cryptocurrency? I don't know what you have your money in, but feel free to start a conversation below. I will be responding to all of your guys' comments and whatnot because I really am curious. And if you're feeling like hot stuff, subscribe to the channel. Deuces.